In 2011, Maserati unveiled the concept of their first SUV. Back then, it was called the Kabang. Thankfully, both the name and the design have evolved into this, the gorgeous-looking Maserati Levante. The back is muscular, with those gorgeous twin tailpipes. It's got a fantastic rear haunches. The side profile is athletic and sleek. There's those signature vents on the front wing, and this car's sitting on 20-inch wheels. But the truly spectacular aspect of this SUV is the front. Just look at that. Fantastic headlights and spots, and that grille is fab. All in all, this is one awesome looking SUV. So let's take a closer look. Just have a quick look in the boot, which you can open with the key fob. Just two taps and there she goes. And there's plenty of space in there for luggage, golf clubs, whatever. So this is a proper SUV. And you can close it with another two clicks. Again, all very nice indeed. The interior of the car is oozing Italian style, as I guess it should be, as it's a Maserati. There's a Maserati Trident there on the centre of a leather steering wheel. Instrument cluster, signature Maserati, very modern, all the usual auto technology, and a very, very nicely designed. It's got an 8.4-inch screen, touchscreen. Uses Maserati, call it Maserati Touch Control. Very easy to control. You can either actually touch with your fingers, which means you leave those horrible fingerprints, or you can use this dial here. Very simple to control, and the infotainment system itself is really good. What else can I tell you? I really like this centre console. I like the height of it. It's bulky and stylish. This wood trim is fantastic. I like the bulky gear lever, and the drive modes can be controlled here. There's off-road with that button there. There's sport. If you push it once, I hope you can hear the engine note change here. If you push it once, can you hear that? There's a real growl now from this car. It's fantastic. If you push it again, it puts a sport suspension on, as you can see there on this on the instrument cluster. I've got absolutely no complaints about this interior. Plenty of room in the back, plenty of style, a very, very good place to be indeed. Now, personally, I wouldn't take this car off-road because I'd be absolutely petrified. I was going to damage those lovely wheels. But you can take it off-road. I mean, it's designed to be able to do that, and I'm sure some people will. And it's got, there are different ride heights. It's got five ride heights which are controlled here. So obviously, if you want to increase the ground clearance, then you increase the ride height. There are two settings for that. Then there's a normal, and then there's two lower settings for driving on the highway. So the car is also extremely versatile. I love this car because it feels a bit different. Don't ask me why it feels different. Maybe it's because it's a Maserati and I expect something special from it. But whatever it is, it works. Now, the car is powered by a 3-litre twin turbo V6. It's got 430 brake horsepower and 580 Nm of torque. So it doesn't hang around. And the great thing about driving this car, A, it's a head turner, for sure it's a head turner. But B, it's the noise that comes from this engine. Now, as I said earlier when I was talking about the interior of the car, if you push the sport button, which I'll do now, straight away you get a different sound out of this car. You can hear that. There's a Maserati snarl, which is really, really great. I just love that. The engine's mated to an 8-speed automatic gearbox. You can use the manual settings and you can use these paddle shifts here. But it works really well, and in sport, when you slow up and it actually changes down, the noise it makes is fab. And that snarling and popping on the overrun, and that is just fantastic. Absolutely love it to death. Listen to that. I mean, this is really entertaining driving. You know, it's up against some really serious rivals in the form of, you know, the Porsche Cayenne, the BMW X5, Audi Q5 or Q7. They're all quality cars, but this is definitely up there with them. Not only is that twin turbo V6 entertaining with the noise that comes out of the exhaust, but it's quite potent and propels this car from 0 to 100 kilometres in around 5 seconds, and it does so with plenty of excitement. So I've got to say that the Maserati Levante S is a magnificent SUV. You know, it was named Levante, is the name of a Mediterranean wind, and pardon the cliche, but it's blown me away.